If you're involved in manufacturing, then I'm sure you've noticed just how much data is involved. I mean, for something even as simple as this coffee cup, for example, you've got a whole bunch of attributes like dimensions, colors, design, weight, what materials were used, how much those materials cost, how much the finished product costs, how much it'll cost to ship. And that's just for a cup. Now imagine how many attributes we could list about something more complicated, like this laptop. Good thing that there's software to help manage and distribute all of that data then, right? And that's what we're going to talk about in this video. Product information management, or PIM software for manufacturers. We'll go over what it is and how it works, what kind of data it can handle, and how it can benefit manufacturers in particular. Remember that you can use the chapter links down below if you want to skip ahead to a certain section. As the name suggests, product information management, or PIM software, is software that can help you manage your product information, as in store, edit, and share it. In some ways, it's kind of like a supercharged Google Sheets, Drive, or Dropbox, since PIM tools are often cloud-based and let you store all of your product data together with your other digital assets like your product images, videos, manuals, PDFs, and so on. Unlike those other tools, however, PIM lets you see everything at once in a convenient, more easily searchable system. There are some clever things that PIM tools can do by combining the best bits of both spreadsheets and cloud storage services. A great example of this is how PIM software lets you link digital assets to your products and their data, which combines the organization aspect of a spreadsheet with the storage function of a cloud drive. Doing this means that from that point on, you'll be able to find, manage, and export those files much more easily since they're already connected to their relevant products. On top of that, since it's specialized in product information, PIM tools have tons of additional features that you won't find in either spreadsheets or cloud drives, and that are specifically designed to make dealing with your product information as easy as possible. There's things like the ability to automate data transfers, whether they're coming in from your ERP platform or going out to your sales channels or retail partners. There are features to resize product images on export, quickly sort through your data, make super fast bulk edits. Oh, and you'll love this. It's even got security features so that you can limit who can see or edit certain information. Anyway, we'll get into those features in more detail a bit later on. Before that though, let's look at the different manufacturing related data that PIM software can handle. There is a massive range, but here are some of the most important types. First, there's technical product specifications, so detailed information about your products, which includes things like dimensions, material, weight, and possibly a lot more depending on how simple or how technically advanced your products are. Again, think of the coffee cup compared to the laptop. Then we have digital assets, which, as previously mentioned, are the files and multimedia associated with your products. So images, videos, manuals, spec sheets, and so on. PIM software can store these assets, link them to your products, and export everything together to your other channels or into one downloadable file. Depending on the asset type, it may also be able to do a bit more than that. Like something cool that I briefly mentioned earlier, how some PIM tools can change the size or format of an image for each of the different places that you're sending your data, but without creating unnecessary separate copies in your system. You just need one master copy in there. PIM software also has some features to handle information related to the life cycle of a product. So the files used for everything from design and development to managing updates, modifications, and variations of products over time, all the way through to discontinuation and product retirement in some cases. Then there's regulatory compliance data. So everything to do with meeting industry standards and regulations throughout the manufacturing process, as well as the documentation and certifications necessary for different markets. Now, this data can be crucial depending on what you're manufacturing, since certain areas are very strict about meeting these regulations. Think healthcare or aerospace, for example. There's also quality control data, AKA information related to quality checks and product testing results, which is also pretty important for the manufacturing process. On that note, a massive part of PIM software is related to sales and marketing data. So the information for your various sales channels, marketing campaigns, product placements and promotional activities if you're selling B2C, or for your sales team to use when negotiating with potential resellers and retail partners if you're selling B2B. If you're selling or reselling internationally, this of course includes product information in multiple languages adapted for different regional requirements and cultural nuances. Similarly, if you're selling B2C on multiple e-commerce platforms, then naturally you're gonna have to have different versions of your product information for each of those as well. We also can't forget pricing information, including standard prices, discount pricing structures, special offers, and price variations for those different markets or customer segments. Okay, so that covers what manufacturing data PIM software can handle, but what does it actually do with that data once it's got it? Well, first and foremost, PIM software provides one central repository where you can keep all of your data and assets. And in some cases, you can even automate the data upload process, making it easier to transfer information from other systems, like I mentioned earlier. Getting everything in one place gives you and your team a central source of truth to work from with shared access that lets multiple people or teams easily view or add information in the system, but within the limits that you set for them. These permission settings mean that you can give them view-only access if you want to make sure that they don't accidentally change something that they shouldn't, or even block them from viewing or editing certain attributes if you need them to be able to edit some things, but you don't want them seeing other sensitive information. Once all of that information and your assets are in the PIM tool, there are specialized features to help you quickly sort through all of your data to find the information that you need, and then edit it in bulk when necessary. For example, imagine that you're a clothing manufacturer and you go from using a 50-50 polycotton blend in some of your shirts to a 65% cotton blend to give your customers that extra little bit of comfort. PIM software will make it easy for you to track down the relevant products and change that attribute for all of them at once without having to make a bunch of individual manual edits for each and every shirt affected. PIM software also comes with features to help maintain the accuracy and completeness of your data, like the ability to restrict the options for a certain attribute to only a set list. So if you know that you only make a product in black, white, and gray, for example, you can make it so that those are the only color options someone can choose from when they're adding that information in. Combine that with tools to check how much information has been filled in for each of your products and automated workflow features, and suddenly it's much easier to avoid inaccurate or incomplete information ending up in front of your retail partners or your customers. On that note, PIM software also makes it a lot easier to get your information where it needs to be, thanks to multiple options for sharing your data and assets, whether we're talking about integrating with the other parts of your tech stack, like your ERP, your inventory management, or your multi-channel listing management systems. Sending data to B2C or D2C sales channels, like marketplaces and e-commerce platforms. Or getting product information out to your distributors, wholesalers, and retailers if you're selling B2B. By the way, if you'd like to learn about how PIM software could benefit your distributors and retailers as well, check out the description for some information that you can send their way. Anyway, PIM software gives you a quick way to get all of the data and assets that you need into one downloadable file, like a PDF, XML, JSON, CSV, and so on, so that you can then send it to wherever it needs to go without having to spend time gathering and formatting that data yourself. On top of that, there are automation features to speed up the process even more, like data feeds that get your information and assets into other systems directly, or online catalogs that you can share that automatically update themselves based on the latest information in your PIM system. All right, now let's take a look at some of the key benefits that PIM software can provide for manufacturers. Firstly, and perhaps most obviously, we have more efficient data management overall. Using specialized software to handle all of your data is 1,000 times more efficient than having everything scattered around spreadsheets, cloud drives, and wherever else, thanks to all of the functions that I've just mentioned that can help you streamline your various data management processes. A significant result of this increased efficiency is massively reducing your time to market. In fact, we recently spoke to a company that now gets their product to market 24 times faster since they started using PIM. And there is a link to that story down in the description. This benefit only becomes more pronounced as you start to sell on more and more marketplaces and other sales channels, or work with more and more resellers and retail partners, since a PIM tool takes out so much of the hassle of dealing with multiple versions of your data and sending them out to wherever they need to go. It also makes it so much easier to have multiple people work on your data. I mean, who would have thought that shared access and collaboration features can be a game changer? Jokes aside though, the quality of your data is going to improve overall, whether it's in terms of keeping everything accurate and up to date, or in terms of being able to enrich your products with detailed descriptions, high quality images, and other attributes that will ultimately enhance how your products appear in their final listings. That in turn is going to lead to an improved customer experience for your client base, whether you're selling B2B or to customers directly, which, all going well, will then increase your sales and profit margins. And if we're being honest, that is the ultimate goal, right? There's a lot more to say on this topic. So if you'd like to learn more, I've left some more resources down in the description. But if you really want to know if PIM software would be a good fit for your manufacturing company, then your best bet is to speak to a PIM expert directly so that they can evaluate your specific situation. To get in touch with the team here at Politics, again, just check the description. Anyway, thanks for watching and don't forget to subscribe, comment, join our mailing list, read our blog, and see you next time.